Doing a quick mic audio test, don't mind me. Alright, hello, welcome to the stream. We are playing Mario Kart 8. Draven is going to be racing against Amarillo College today. I think Draven may have slipped his opponent up on a banana, but I was not too sure what happened there. Going into lap two now. Draven's got a pretty steady lead over his opponent so far. He's got all 10 coins, which means he's experiencing the max possible speed you can get. Almost to the final stretch of this race. Going into the final lap now. I think his opponent might be purposefully slowing down so that way he can get some of those better items to help him catch up. Thank you. Looks like they got a star, which is not going to help them very much in getting caught up. It gives them a slight speed boost, but nothing too meaningful. And that is going to be it for game number one, going to Draven. We are now into game number two. Draven is swiftly going to take the first place spot with a convenient red shell. And I'm not sure what's going on with the Be Right Back screen. That is not something on our end. That would be something on Google's end or the NJC's end. But it is supposed to display all seven games next to each other, but it only displays one, which may mislead anyone watching to think that Draven has already won the whole game, which he has not. Going into lap number two, Draven still has a pretty solid lead. Barely avoids the boomerang. Good thing he's paying attention. Going into the final lap now. His opponent is going to need to get probably a triple red shell, I imagine, if he wants to take the lead here. Or maybe a mushroom, but I'm not sure if that would help him there very much. Draven is just absolutely zooming here. His opponent might take the lead here in the last second. But it may be too late. And that it is. That is game number two, going to Draven. We are now going into number three on Sweet Sweet Canyon. I always thought this map reminded me of that one video game from Wreck-It Ralph where they race and everything's made out of candy. He's just maintaining a really solid lead the whole time, not slipping up at all. He avoids a red shell. He gets a horn, which is going to be really useful for deterring any kind of items that his opponent might use, and if he decides to speed up next to him, Draven can knock him out as well. We're now going into the final lap. Draven uses the horn to get rid of a red shell. I think the opponent's got another one though, but he avoids it with a bomb. That was really close. His opponent must be wondering what's going on. The third one is going to hit him though, but I think his lead is significant enough that it will not really matter. And he's got two defensive items now, which is very beneficial. But his opponent passes him in the last stretch of the game. That is incredibly unfortunate for Draven. That is going to be game number 3, going to Amarillo College. We are now going into game number 4 on Wario Stadium. And if there's anyone in the chat with us today, let us know what the mix sounds like. Is it good? Is it bad? Is anybody adjusted? It helps us out a lot. Draven's got a very, very, very slight lead above his opponent right now. I think a singular mushroom is all they really need to pass him. Barely avoids the red shell, but he's gonna get hit by the second one. Is it gonna be enough for his opponent to pass him? It is. Boo now has the lead. Draven's got two mushrooms here. He could put this to good work with these shortcuts. Going into the final lap, Draven's got to make something happen. Oh, but he misses the boost. They use their shell. Draven doesn't hit him with his own. This is going to be really, really close. It all comes down to these last couple items. And he got a banana. That is not at all what he wanted. And he gets slowed down in the dirt. I think this is over. And that is going to be game number 4, going to AC College. Thank you. Alright, we're now going into game number 5 on Music Park. I've always thought this was one of the coolest maps to come from this game. Draven's fallen behind just a little bit. He can absolutely catch up here. Draven's taken a slight lead over his opponent. He's just got to maintain it now. But he falls off the map trying to hit the shortcut. That is going to be devastating to his progress. He gets 4 mushrooms, which he could put to really good use, I know it. And he does, that's enough for him to pass his opponent, but he's just got a very, very, very slight lead. He gets hit with a fireball. His opponent successfully hits the shortcut. Draven's back in second place. Draven's not getting the items he wants. But I think he can do it in this last stretch here. 2 red shells. One of them falls into a hole. And that is going to be it for game number 4. Or 5. Alright, we are now going into game number 6. If the player from Amarillo College wins this game, they will win the match. Draven's just barely taking the lead here. He hits his opponent with a bomb. That's going to slow them down a lot. But his opponent's coming right back at him with a red shield, but I think it passed him? I'm not really sure what happened there. A banana and a bomb. This is looking really good for Draven so far. Going into the final lap, Draven's got a very great lead over his opponent. Red shells are coming in slowly. One of these is going to have to stop him. But Draven's still holding a good lead. If his opponent gets another red shell here, it could be over. I think Draven's in the clear, though. The triple red shell might end this race. And that is going to be a successful game number 6 for Draven. To the 7th and final race. Whoever wins this race wins it all. They're pretty neck and neck right now, but Draven gets the slipstream. He's pretty far ahead of his opponent so far. Going into lap number 2. Going into the final lap. Draven is getting hit by all kinds of things right now, but he's still in the lead. He gets hit with the boomerang though. Who's gonna take first place? Draven's gonna have to get pretty lucky with his items here. He gets a mushroom though, I don't know if that's what he wants. And I believe that is going to be it for this match. This was a very close race between both parties, but congratulations to Amarillo College for winning.